Science is real, from the Big Bang to DNA.
Hi, welcome back to another virtual chemistry lab. All right, today we are going to be heating up a mixture so that we can figure out the composition, the percent composition of that mixture. All right, you see here I've got my electronic balance, I've got my crucible and top, a wire gauze. I've got my ring stand, my ring, my clay triangle, pair of crucible tongs, and my trusty Bunsen burner. All right, so what we're going to do first is we are going to go ahead and take the mass of our empty crucible. So as I come in here to grab this, I'll take a moment and you'll record that mass. Now, when you record the mass, make sure you're recording all the digits. All right, after we do that, we're going to take it off and we're going to add in the mixture. Now everyone's getting a different mixture, so we're going to add in the mixture and then come in and go ahead and record that mass. All right, so we recorded that mass as well. Excellent. Now, we're going to go ahead and start our setup here. All right, so the first thing we want to do is we want to make sure that our ring is going to be not too high away from our Bunsen burner. So we're going to want a decent sized flame, probably about a few inches there, but we don't want it to be like, you know, so high. We want the bottom of the flame to kiss the bottom of our crucible. So I'm going to bring this down, estimated here, just about there, just so that we have a few inches and we'll still kiss our flame, or the bottom of our crucible there. All right, great. Now we're going to move the Bunsen burner away. And we're going to place our crucible with our mixture in it, and we're going to place our crucible top on it. Now, notice we didn't take the initial mass with the top, and that's because these tops tend to fall off. Because we don't put them on straight, we leave them ajar, and that's so that the gases can escape, and also but still block any kind of popping that might happen and cause a safety hazard. All right, so we've got that there, and you see I turned the clay triangle like up, to sort of help catch the crucible top, because crucible tops, once they get heated due to thermal expansion and just general jiggling, fall off and break all the time. And that's why we didn't include it in our initial measurement, because they're kind of unpredictable. That's why we also have so many tops in our storage room. Okay, great. Now, next thing you want to do is light this Bunsen burner. You notice we're not going to light it underneath here, because we want to be able to get the flame the way we want it before it encounters our experiment. So I'm going to make sure I'm turning my little shaft here to make sure I have a good oxygen, plenty of oxygen coming in, but I don't want too much. I'm also going to make sure the nozzle is open so that I'm getting plenty of gas. Okay, and then I'm going to hook it up to the gas and I'm going to light the flame. All right, so now that we have a nice, beautiful flame, we're going to take that flame and we're going to move it underneath our experiment so it can get started. Now, if you're not comfortable lighting a Bunsen burner, there will be a link so you can watch a video about how to light a Bunsen burner. If you don't have that skill, because you should have that skill. You notice I'm going to be holding it by the base, and that's because the base doesn't get hot. The flames are up here. So as long as I touch it on the bottom, it's perfectly safe to move. Okay, I don't want to go waving it around as my friends, but I can move it from one spot to another safely. So I'm going to carefully slide it under here, and it should be just kissing the bottom of my crucible there. Now, you know crucibles, they get hot, okay? They get hot fast. So even though this has been over the flame only for a very short time, it's already getting quite warm. So often because of the way it looks, students sort of touch it by just, you know, try to move it gently just because they're trying to get it in the right position while it's already hot, and then they melt their fingers. So don't ever do that. All right, so we're going to let this heat up for about 10 minutes. And while it's heating, of course, we're not going anywhere because we have an open flame and we have an experiment going. All right, 10 minutes is up. So you'll see I turned off my flame and now I get the fun job of letting this cool. It's going to take about 5 minutes to cool. All right, so after it's been cooling a little while, now I'm going to go ahead and take it off of the clay triangle using my crucible tongs and my wire gauze. So I'm going to carefully move the top on top of it, and I'm going to come in underneath here and carefully lift the crucible gently between the tongs and move it to my wire gauze to help with the balance so things don't fall off. I'm going to carefully lay it on my table there, and then I can carefully remove the top if I wish so that it can air out and cool some more. Now, of course, how do I know when it's really cool enough I can touch? Well, you got to test it, right? And we know how to test something that's hot. You bring the back of your hand up to it, and if you can feel heat radiating off of it, you know it's too hot to touch. So if you bring your back of your hand, which is very sensitive, to it and there, you don't feel any heat, then hey, probably you're okay. The next test, of course, is just to do sort of gently touch it. Yeah, is it hot? Just like you would do at home. Okay, so at this point, however long it's been, I've decided it's cool enough to touch. So I'm gonna bring this over, I'm gonna pick up my crucible, and I'm gonna take the mass again. All right, so now we have our recorded mass after our first heating. Now, just a friendly reminder, we needed to wait till everything cooled because we cannot put a warm object on a balance. It throws off the balance. So we have to wait till it gets to room temperature before we're able to actually take that measurement. All right, well, we've done our first heating, and now we're going to do another heating. Why? Well, how do we know if it's done? So we're going to go ahead and put this back on there with our top. There you go. I'm going to light my Bunsen burner. I'm going to put my Bunsen burner underneath. And this time I'm going to let it heat up for about 5 minutes because that initial heating probably drove most of the reaction, but now we're going to dry some more. So we'll wait about 5 minutes, again, still being aware of our surroundings, still making sure we're keeping an eye on our experiment. All right, so we're done with those 5 minutes. So I've turned off my gas. I'm going to move this out of the way again. And once again, now we're gonna wait for this to cool. How long will it take to cool? Probably another 5 minutes because it got just as hot, just not for as long. So we're waiting. So now, we'll assume now it's cool enough. Still, we're going to do the same thing again. Let's take the measurement again. All right. Is the reaction finished now? Well, you need to make sure you're getting all the data you need from this reaction by heating and reheating until you are 100% certain the reaction is finished. How will you know? Oh, you'll know. All right, so now we will just rinse and repeat until you've decided you have the data you need.
Science is real.